Hi, I'm Jesse with Mastercam, and in this video, we're going to talk about how you can leverage Mastercam and your Haas control to collect information about your part mid-program. This is a game changer for leveraging technology you may already have. Most of us are already using probing on a regular basis when setting up our fixturing and locating our parts. However, this is just a small part of what probing is capable of. Over the next few minutes, we'll walk through how to set up a probing routine that can check the diameter of hole features mid-program. This would allow an operator to know if the holes are bored to specification and be able to adjust accordingly without having to open the door on the machine, let alone take the part out. We'll be using Productivity Plus, which is the probing add-in for Mastercam. It's located on the Toolpath tab under Utilities. If this is the first time you're creating a probing operation in a file, the Select Probe dialog will open. We'll edit the probe to match Tool 41 on our UMC750SS, which has a 40+1 capacity tool changer. Once the probe is configured, we can click OK and the probing dialog will open. Let's start with a macro 3-point operation and select this circular bore that will serve as a mating pin location for the female portion of this mold. We'll also select the smaller hole. Since all the like holes are being cut with the same process, selecting one of each should give us a good feel for the accuracy of the remaining hole sizes. At this point, we can end selection and probing will bring in all the information for the holes we selected. If we save this probing operation and look at it in backplot, we can see the motion that probing has created. Now we need to tell the probing routine what to do with the information it has gathered. Let's go back into the probing parameters and choose Machine Update. We'll tell probing to write to a machine macro variable. Any available variables can be used for this, but for this example, we'll use pound 800. Using the set strategy, we'll write the value of the diameter of circle 1. Next, we'll repeat that process for circle 2. This time, we'll use variable pound 801. Once the code is posted out, we can move over to the machine. As we saw on the model in Mastercam, we have two different sizes of hole that we'll be checking with the probe to provide some in-process feedback to the operator. If we run the probing routine, the values for these features will be written to the macros we chose, but they won't be displayed on the control by default. In order to make sure they're easily visible, we'll have to do a little setup. Navigate to Current Commands, then move into the Timers tab. Here we'll see labels for Macro Variable 1, Macro Variable 2, and the Macro Assign fields. Since we wrote our diameters to pound 800 and pound 801 in Mastercam, we'll need to duplicate that in the control setup by entering these values under their respective Macro Assign fields. Once this is done, we want to give the operator some labels in order to better understand what these values mean when they pop up on the control. I prefer to include the nominal value in the name, so let's call them 0.625 hole and 0.425 hole, respectively. Since we haven't run the probing routine yet, the variables are displaying 0, which is their default value. Now that the controller is configured, let's load the posted probing routine. It's important to keep in mind that because Renishaw Productivity Plus leverages macro programming, we can't run the program directly off the USB drive. Instead, we'll copy it into memory before we run it. Let's hit cycle start and see this probing operation in action. You can see that the probe is behaving exactly as we simulated in Mastercam, measuring the large bore first, and then moving over to the smaller one. Once the program is finished, the corresponding measurements from the probe are displayed with their labels, and it's easy to see that in this instance, the holes are slightly undersized. This means that the operator would know that they can make a wear adjustment if needed and rerun the boring operations to get those holes up to specification. In MasterCam, it's also possible to create logic that would make tool compensation happen automatically off the probed measurements and then recut the holes. Productivity Plus is capable of much more than these simple probing routines as well. Tool breakage detection, automated workpiece setting, and autonomous logic are done in the same fashion. And these probing operations can be intertwined with regular machining to make for an intelligent and informative NC program. We hope we've provided some insight into some of the technology that's available both inside MasterCam and your Haas CNC that can help you improve your quality and process control by leveraging tools you probably already have.